Hey everyone, it's Monica. So I'm finally back. This isn't really a project share video. It is one of my flower feature series videos. It's been a hot minute since I did one of these. I've just kind of been in not a crafting funk. I have the mojo. I have ideas of what I want to create. My problem is I don't want to create. I don't want to sit down. I come and I sit in my craft room and I turn my computer on and I just watch movies. Or I'll sit and read. I just physically don't feel like crafting. And I've been in this situation probably for the past I would say my last design team project I posted at the end of March. So I've literally been like this for the last 2 months. I did create a set of cards about 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago for my sister's birthday. But aside from that, it was kind of a forced situation. I didn't really want to create it. But yeah, that's where I am. I'm hoping to be crafting soon. But when I do start feeling like crafting, I definitely will have all kinds of stuff because I definitely have all kinds of ideas of what I want to create. So I figured let's try to jump back into it and do a flower feature series video. Again, it's been a couple of months since I did one and a few of you definitely liked it. So let me go ahead and get to it. So for today's flower feature, we're going to be doing another Sue Wilson flower dye. This is one of the flower dyes that I really love to use. So let's go ahead and get to it. This one is going to be the Sue Wilson Orange Blossom. So let me go ahead and get my sign out of the way and we'll go ahead and get to it. So for the dye itself, we've got a couple of different things. We're mainly going to be focusing on her regular orange blossom dye. For several of her flowers, her older flowers, she had a complete petal, which is basically the solid petal, and then she had an open petal, which is an outlining dye. I'm going to show you both, but I'm only really going to be focusing on the complete petals since this is the traditional type of flower dyes that are out there. Now, let's go ahead and get into it. I have the other one right here. They look basically exactly the same, except on the open petals, it is just an outline. I will show you a sample of a different flower that I use the open petals on. To be honest, I was just too lazy to cut this one out and do a sample, but there's plenty of samples with the complete petal, which is the main focus. This is basically a complementary dye, but it is coordinating, so I did want to go ahead and mention it. Okay, so for this particular dye, there is a difference in the amount of dyes that you get between the complete petals and the open petals. The complete petals, you get 16 different pieces. Granted, not all of them are flowers. You definitely have a couple of different size in the stamens. You get, I believe it's 9 different flower sizes in here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you get 4 of one and 5 of the other. So you get 16 in the complete petals and 12 in the open petals. But again, we're not going to focus on this one. This is just a complementary dye. This is not necessary. Okay, so for the complete petals, this does have quite a few different flower sizes in it. You get one dye of each size of the flowers. This particular one does have 2 different styles in it. Granted, I only use this larger one, the one with the pointed edges. You have 4 of these particular dyes. The other ones are definitely still 5 petal flowers, but they're more rounded. The petals have a different shape to them, and the petals themselves don't go straight out. They're at a curve, so it's like as if they're turning. But I'll show you a sample cut out of that. So this is a particular die set. Let me go ahead and take it out so you can kind of see all of them. Ah, they're getting stuck. Okay, so this is the die set that you get. This is my favorite die shape. You get a large one. This large flower is approximately 2 3/8 of an inch wide. The next size down, let's measure it the same way, is approximately 2 1/8 of an inch. Then the next one down is approximately 1 7/8. And the next size down for that same shape is approximately, what is that? 1 5/8 of an inch, give or take. This other size, the largest one is 1 1/2, and the smallest being, what is that? Oh, I can't even see the ruler. Hold on. My blind eyes. It's about 5/8 of an inch wide. So you have several different sizes. So in reality, you technically have two different flower shapes in this die set. So let me get this back inside. Now, price point. This is a pricey die. Retail for this particular die is going to be $29 for this die set. Again, you get 16 pieces, you get two different flower types, and you get a whole bunch of these little sizes in these little stamens that you can put in the center of your flowers. I personally rarely ever use those little stamens. My use of these, again, is this pointed flower here. So, like I said, retail price on this is $29. You can typically find it on, like, Amazon or 123 Stitch has it. Between $22 to $23, roughly. Now, if you're looking at the UK sites, it's been a while since I looked for this flower, so I can't really give you a price comparison, but for those in the States, those are the most easily found places, is Amazon and 123 Stitch for this. So you're looking at about $23 for this flower die set. So let's move this to the side. Now, you could use the die as is. You don't need any other components. But they do have a coordinating stamp set. She typically creates two styles when it comes to the stamps. I know she did for her older dies. Her newer dies, I've noticed that she does one coordinating stamp set. Now, you don't need the stamp set to work the die. I personally like the coordinating stamp set, and 9 out of 10 times when I use this flower, I do use a coordinating stamp set, but you can create without it. This is what the coordinating stamp set looks like. This stamp set retail, I actually have not seen MSRP on this because I have not found this in, the only place I found this in the States was at Ecstasy Crafts, and they have it for like $11.83, something like that. But I would say if you're buying it from a UK site, you're gonna be paying roughly $8 to $12 depending on where it is that you find it, and that's before shipping. But this is a coordinating stamp set. Here is the part number. It is UMS661. And oops, I forgot to mention the part number on the flower. It is CED1445. For the open petals, that part number is CED1446. Okay, so these two go together. When it comes to her flowers, I typically do buy the coordinating stamp set if it's available. Typically, when I buy the die, I have to go searching elsewhere for the stamp. So sometimes I might not get them right away, but I eventually do like to have one of the coordinating stamp sets that goes to the flowers. If you're looking at these when you're buying them retail, you're looking at like $42, give or take. And that's MSRP. I never buy anything MSRP. Typically, when I buy something, I buy it 30, 40, 50% off. I wait for sales, all that good stuff. So I never pay retail price for these. Now, you guys, in my previous videos, you guys know that I go back and forth. Everybody loves Heartfelt Creation flowers. They're beautiful. Don't get me wrong. I have a few. I don't own very many because I don't think they're worth it price point wise. And there's a few things about it that do irritate me. And this little stupid thing fell over, so let's move it. For example, with Heartfelt Creations, typically when they have flower sets, you have to buy two different there's two different flower dies. You get one die for larger flowers and one die for the same style in the smaller one. I did a review on, the peony, I think it was, where I only had the large die, and I kind of gave my thoughts there. If you want to see that video, I'll go ahead and link it up here in the iCard. Otherwise, I do have the flower feature playlist. You can check that out. I'll put it in the description box below, and you can see the different flower dye reviews that I've done. So far, I've only really done, I think this is number 3, I think. Who knows? It hasn't been very many. Okay, like I said, my thing with the Sue Wilson, which is the one that I own the most flowers of, while the initial price point of the dye is high, it's up there, you get a lot of dyes in there and you get several different sizes. My main issue with when it comes to like heartfelt, like I said, the size availability, you usually have to break it up into 2 dyes. Their dyes retail $30 a pop. So if you want 2 dye sets, retail $60. Realistically, you're probably spending about $50 if you buy them from different websites when with their lower sales prices. I don't want to pay that for just the flowers. They're awesome. The shape of their dyes are great because they're all together, so you just line it up, as opposed to these that are loose and individual. So, I mean, each one has its pros and cons. But price point wise, these make more sense to me. When I do my flowers, I love several layers. I don't like just 1 or 2 layers when it comes to my flowers. Typically, when I do flowers, you're looking at 5 to 6 layers per flower. Occasionally, I do flowers with 2 layers, 3 layers, and that's when you get to the smaller sizes of the flowers. But I don't use that often. I have a lot more options when it comes to the Sue Wilson flower dyes. Okay, so let me quit rambling about the dyes themselves, and let's show you some samples. So, this one here is what the flower looks like using the largest petal. You got the, let's bring the dye back. So, for this flower, I used 2 of this large petal. Then I skipped the next size down and I went to the 3rd size down for the shape. I used 2 of these. And then I used 1, which is hiding, oh, no, it's right here. I used 1 of these in the center to create this flower. So I have 5 layers on this one. I could have done another layer, done 2 of each size on here to make it even fuller. But for this one, I have 5. I typically use 5 when it comes to this one. So this is what it looks like stamped and embossed. I embossed it with Stampendous Detail Gold embossing powder. I don't have a gem in the center because I haven't decided what color I'm going to be using because I'm using this on a project. So this is what the flower looks like. This is the largest one. Now, if you want to see the flower not embossed, here is what it looks like. It is the same size, same amount of layers. This is just stamped in black ink on this blue cardstock. If we're looking at the next size down, this one does not have any stamping. For this one is a smaller flower. I used the 2nd largest die. I used 2 petals, and then I went ahead and I used, did I use 2? It looks like I used 2 of the smaller ones as well. So this one only has 4 layers. Now let's go ahead. I should have shown you the petals cut out first, but I forgot. So here's what they look like stamped and embossed. Here is the larger flower. Ooh. This one is the next size down, followed by this one. And this one is relatively close in size to that one there. And there's this one here. So that's what they look cut out. Now to me, after I stamp them, aligning them with the die isn't that big of an issue for me. I very rarely have an error when I'm lining it up. They're pretty straightforward. Most of the, for this particular flower, the shape of the petals is practically the same for all of them, so it's not like you have to find which petal lines up with which flowers like some of the other flower dyes I have. So that's what it looks like stamped out. Now, for the shape of the other one, like I was telling you, it's still a 5 petal flower, but as you can see, they have a fatter petal base. It's kind of, it goes from wider to the most narrow point. And the petals have a little curve as if they're curving to the left. As opposed to this one, it goes from narrow to wide to slightly a pointed narrow shape at the top. So you do have two different shapes in this die set. I don't think I've ever used the shape. It's not a shape I particularly like, so I don't really use it. I guess these would be good because of the little curve to it, where if you're making a really 3D flower and you want that curved bud in the center, these would probably work well for that. Okay, that is pretty much it when it comes to the flower die itself. I will go ahead and show you a couple of samples on cards where I've used them. Oh, baby, I'm recording a video.
I want to say hi.
Not today. Oh. Go, go, go. Shoo, shoo, shoo. Mm. I'll get you in just a second. Okay. My little one. Let's try to come up in here. All right. This card I created about a year ago. This is what the flower looks like. And it's kind of been flattened. I have to fluff it back up. But this is what the flower looks like on a card. So here is the same full-size flower as this one. It's actually the same color as this one here. And here's where I used just two layers of the smaller flower. So that's what it looks like, stamped and on a card. Now, as I was telling you with the other flower die, this is what it looks like. So for the open petals, you can use it either this way, like I did on this card, where you actually line it up and glue it down to the solid petal. That way it gives you that outline in a different color. You could either use it this way. That's how I have it on this card. Or, now this is a different flower, but it's the same type of flower die, where I use the solid petals as my main base, and the final layering of the flower, I use the open petal. Now this is one of the poinsettias, so it has this line in the center, but it's the same concept where you have just the outline die. It's not filled in, you see through the entire die. This is how I typically use the open petals, either like this or as a finishing touch. I see a lot of people use these open petals as the flower themselves, and they just stagger the different sizes as you normally would with regular flowers. I personally don't like that look, so I either use it as an outline or as a finishing touch. Again, as I mentioned, these open petal dies are definitely not a necessity. They're a luxury. Okay, so that is pretty much it when it comes to the flower die itself. Again, I personally love this flower. I use it a lot. For me, it's worth every single penny. And I get quite a few different sizes from one die. I don't have to buy multiple dies and multiple stamp sets as you do with Heartfelt Creations. Some other flower dies that I do have are some of the 3D dies from Cottage Cuts. One of their flowers is one of my favorites, but again, with theirs, it's very limited to how many sizes you can get. When it comes to the flowers, they don't have coordinating stamp sets either. So, as you guys know, these are one of my reasons why these Sue Wilson flower dies are some of my favorites. You get a lot more variety. So to me, you get more bang for your buck. Yes, they are on the higher price point, but to me, they're much more worthwhile because I can use them on several different types of projects. I do large projects, I do small projects, so using the different sizes definitely works for me without having to buy two different sets of dies and two different sets of stamps to go ahead and have a different size range. Because I'm definitely one of those that I'm a collector when it comes to a particular type. If I buy one, I have to buy the other. Like, for example, the Heartfelt. I have one flower die, one stamp die. I have to have the smaller one. To me, it has to, because I do so many layers when it comes to my flowers. I'm not satisfied with just two size petals on one die for the large and then two on the small. I need it all together all at once so I can make a much more fuller flower. I guess that's kind of about it. If you have any questions, comment below. I'm so out of the video practice, so I'm pretty sure I might have missed a couple of points that I usually do in these videos, but I'm trying to jump back into the swing of things. So if I missed anything, comment below and I will answer the best I possibly can. And I will catch you guys in another video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.